If you want to take your design career seriously, then you really want to add these 6 tools into your workflow. From managing time, finances, inspiration, and much, much more, they're going to allow your career to fly to new heights. But there's one resource I've been using for the longest time, and that's Milanote. Milanote allows me to streamline my design process with mood boards, to-do lists, inspiration, and much, much more. It's great to have all of my creativity, my ideas, and my concepts in one singular place online. So to streamline your design process and to learn more about Milanote, stay tuned to the very end of today's video. Well, welcome back to Satori Graphics on lockdown. I've actually checked the reviews on every edition in today's video, and I've made sure they are top notch and are going to be useful for you in your graphic design career. So within Harvest, you can actually manage your time effectively on separate projects. You can also set up things like invoices for billing clients, and you can even build project sub-projects within a single project. Now there is a free version which you can allow yourself as 2 projects maximum and only 1 person available on that account. One of the most appealing things about this resource is that you can manage your time, so you can keep track of how long you spend on each project. And if you work per hour and you charge per hour, this is really, really useful because you can keep track of exactly how long you're taking on each of your projects. And then when it comes to billing your client for those hours, you can do all of that within Harvest. Now moving on to some inspiration, and this is a website I've never shown on this channel before, and it's actually designinspiration.com. This website is kind of set up and laid out like Pinterest, but one of the really useful things I found on this website is that the search bar doesn't only utilize key search terms, it also utilizes colors. So you could whack in 3 different colors that you want to have inspiration for, and then you're going to be shown various different projects utilizing those colors. You can sign up with Google, which is really handy and quick to do. The quality of work on there is really, really high, I find, for the most part, and you can actually upload your own work as well and save things to a library. So if you want to get inspired and you want to have that boost of creativity, check out designinspiration.com. So the third resource on today's list is another freebie, and it's made by Google, and it's called Google Sheets. Now it kind of works like Excel, Microsoft Excel, in terms of being a spreadsheet, but it has a lot to offer for you and your freelance or graphic design career. From Google Sheets, you can do things like invoicing, you have calendars, a to-do list, and also a budget as well. There's quite a lot on there, and you can access your own account on any kind of computer, and you can grant access to multiple people working on the same sheet, which is really good if you're part of a design team. And again, Google Sheets is free. It's just another resource that's going to handle a lot of the back-end stuff of a career as a graphic designer. The next addition today is Adobe Color, and just wait a minute. I know I've shown this before on this channel, but they've actually got some new features. But if you're not familiar with Adobe Color, I do suggest you check it out anyway, because you have access to many different color schemes and color layouts, which you can play around with and, you know, personalize to your own projects. And they also have some really good inspiration for what the colors could be used for. But the new feature stems from an old one. And the old feature was that you can upload an image and you could pick colors from that image to use as a color scheme in your project. But they've actually gone a step further, and you can upload an image with a gradient, and you can pull a gradient from that image. The fifth one is quite obvious to most people, but I think Dropbox should be on your list of resources as a graphic designer. Dropbox allows you to upload a huge amount of files, you know, into their cloud, and that means you don't take up space on your computer. As graphic designers, it is really important to have somewhere that we can upload images or files and then send them to clients if they're too large. All you need to do is just upload your files, then click the shareable link option, and just post that link to your client. I couldn't do what I do if there wasn't such a service as Dropbox out there. And of course, it is totally free, and there is a pro version as well. But if you have multiple different Google accounts or different emails, you can set up multiple different Dropbox accounts totally for free. As a graphic designer, we obviously need to get paid for our work. And to get paid, we need invoices. Invoice Home is one of the best options out there for creating invoices and sending them to your clients. It is totally free up until the threshold of $1,000 of invoicing per 30 days. But once you go past that, it's only $5 per month to use their service. They also store your past invoices on their website. So if you need to invoice a client again in the future, just pull up that invoice, which does save a lot of time. But yeah, big thanks to Milanote for sponsoring today's video. I really do highly recommend it, and I've been using it for nearly 2 years now myself. You can easily streamline your creative process from start to finish on any project that you're working on, but also it's very easy to share your ideas and your projects with other clients or even work colleagues. So yeah, do check out the links down below for more information on Milanote and start streamlining your creative design process in a more efficient way today. Now, obviously there are more resources that are going to be helpful to you as a graphic designer in your career and so forth, but these are six of the ones that I think are really important and ones that I use on a regular basis. But let me know, which ones do you feel are the most important and what else would you add on this list? And until next time, guys, design your future today. Peace.